Good evening. I'd like to welcome you to week number two of our growth group entitled Moving Mountains. You'll enjoy this evening. Let's do a recap of our message from Sunday. We're talking about moving mountains and basing this off the Lord's Prayer. And today we're dealing with this thought: Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. First of all, this is the humbling part of prayer. The Bible tells us this in 2 Corinthians 7:14, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray. This thought, hallowed be thy name, it means holy is your name, or we are to reverence the name of God. Hallowed be thy name. We are to treat his name like it's the most beautiful name ever spoken, like it's the most important name ever spoken, like it's the most powerful name ever spoken, because it is the most beautiful, most powerful, and most important name that you'll ever speak. One of the great hindrances of prayer is this: misusing the name of the Lord. The scripture tells us in Exodus chapter 20, verse 7, this is the third of the Ten Commandments, it says this: thou shalt not misuse the name of the Lord your God. The Lord will not hold anyone guiltless who misuses his name. We are not to misuse the name of the Lord. I believe if we do, it will hinder our prayers. We're not to use his name as a curse word. We're not to use his name lightly. We are not to use his name in a joking way. We are to reverence his name. Second of all, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. This is the humbling part of prayer. Second of all, this is the refocusing part of prayer. Before we ask God for anything, before we bring any request to God, first of all, we need to take some time and refocus on him. We need to bring him into the center of our thoughts. We need to shift our thoughts off all the things that clutter our minds and bring our minds to focus on him. How do we focus on him? One of the ways we can focus on him is thinking about his name. The Bible says, speaking of Jesus, he is the captain of the hosts of the Lord. He is the author and the finisher of our faith. He is the lion of the tribe of Judah. We speak of Jesus, he is our creator, he is our savior. Jesus is our good shepherd. He's our shield, he's our comforter and counselor. Jesus is our best friend. Second of all, we can refocus first by thinking about his name. Second of all, we can refocus by worship. Worship helps to bring us into God's presence and focus on him. Psalm 22, verse 3 says this: but thou art holy, O thou that inhabits the praises of Israel. God inhabits your praises. The New American Standard Version of the Bible says this: yet you are holy, O you who are enthroned upon the praises of Israel. That God is enthroned upon your praises. We need to worship until we begin to come into his presence. Worship until we have a breakthrough into his presence. Starting off, this may take time, but as you begin to do it every day over the next 40 days, you'll find it easier and easier to break through into God's presence. A third way we can refocus is reading some of the Psalms. In your notes, you'll find a list of some of my favorite Psalms. And maybe tonight you can share with the group some of your favorite Psalms. Some of the Psalms are actually ancient worship songs. They're beautiful, and they'll help you refocus on God. First of all, this part of the Lord's Prayer is the humbling part of prayer. Second, it's the refocusing part of prayer. But it's also the breakthrough part of prayer. Now follow with me. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. There is a connection between hallowing, worshiping the name of God, and then the kingdom of God coming here in our lives. If we want a breakthrough in prayer, we need to break through into the presence of God. Let me say that again. If we want a breakthrough in prayer, and we do over these 40 days, we need to break through into the presence of God. There is a clash between two kingdoms taking place in the world today. First of all, there's this present kingdom. This kingdom that is this fallen world that we are living in a fallen world under the judgment of God that is controlled by selfish people that have been hurt and wounded generation after generation, and these wounds and hurts are passed on from parents to children, and we are living according to John 8 in a world that is under the control of the devil. Yet we see a future kingdom. Revelation chapter 21 verse 4 says, "And he will wipe away every tear from your eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away." So Jesus is going to come and he's going to fix this mess. But also we see in Scripture an inbreaking of the kingdom of God in this present age. This is exciting. This is what we want to experience. Jesus says this, he was speaking and people were complaining and saying that you're casting out devils by the power of the devil, by Beelzebub. And Jesus replied this way. He says, "Now if I drive out demons by Beelzebub, by whom do your followers drive them out? So then they will be your judge. But if I drive out demons by the finger of God, then the kingdom of God has come upon you." I believe God's kingdom still is breaking into this old kingdom and is coming upon us. When a miracle takes place, it is the inbreaking of the kingdom of God. When there's a breakthrough that takes place, it's the inbreaking of the kingdom of God. When someone is set free, it is the inbreaking of the kingdom of God. And I believe God wants to break into your life, that he wants you to have an inbreaking of the kingdom of God over these 40 days. That's breakthrough. That's what we're looking for. The miraculous power of God to break through in our lives and in our church. How do we experience the inbreaking of the kingdom? Today we've dealt with two things. Humble yourself before God and focus on God and come into his presence. God is going to do great things in your life and in your growth group. I believe this in Jesus' name. God bless you, folks. Amen. At this time, we're going to take some time to worship. And as you worship, allow your heart to break into the presence of God and experience an inbreaking in your life.
Confined, he confounds. He will not resign, he resounds. He is not restrained. Oh, hear the sound. Oh, hear the sound. Rocks are falling, the broken calling to the God who moves the mountains. The earth is shaking, the weary waking to the God who moves the mountains. The God who moves the mountains. Yeah. He is not surprised, he surrounds. Cannot be stopped, he astounds. He is drawing near. Oh, hear the sound. Oh, hear the sound. Rocks are falling, the broken calling to the God. You're the God who moves the mountains, the God who moves the mountains. You say speak, and we say move. You say watch what you can do. You say trust, and then you prove. You're the God.
strips away, and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, and through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about
your time of worship. Now I want us to transition to a place of prayer. Let's take the room that you're in right now and turn it into a prayer room, and let's meet with God. Thank you for coming this evening. I hope you've enjoyed your growth group. Feel free to take some more time for some fellowship or additional questions. God bless you, folks.
When the music fades and all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's of worth that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper all.